Before I show you how I made my chemisette, I figured I should probably tell you what a chemisette is. A chemisette is a lot like a dickie. It can either be worn in place of a shirt or over top of one to help create an illusion of a nicer shirt. They could have collars that were attached, or like this one, have detachable collars that can be separately washed. They were worn by both men and women and were very popular throughout the 19th century.
I started with Ageless Patterns number 1849, which gave me a basic idea of what I was going to do. I ended up veering off of the pattern quite a bit though. Once all of my pattern pieces had been cut out, I began cutting them out of my white cotton fashion fabric. I decided to add pin tucks in order to give my chemisette a little bit more visual interest. However, when I was cutting it out, I got distracted and forgot to add the extra bit of fabric. This didn't really end up messing with my plans later, but it would have been nice to have that extra fabric. After all the pieces were cut out of the cotton, I cut out two layers of stiffening. I ended up having to cut two layers because my stiffening was so thin, but if you have a thicker stiffening or are using horsehair canvas, then you might not have to do this bit. Once all the pieces were cut out, I began placing the pin tucks. I tried different methods for placing them, like pinning them or basting them, but I found the easiest and fastest way of doing it was just to iron the pin tucks in place. Once all the pin tucks were in place, I layered them all together. I decided to finish it a little bit differently. Rather than trying to sew it all like a bag, I decided to fold over the excess seam allowance from the back, pinning it and sewing it over the edge on the front panel. I then proceeded to top stitch all the way around it using my machine. This, however, could have been done with hand stitching if you were determined enough. The next part was to create these crescent moon shapes in the back, which would act as closures. I layered the bits together and stitched them. I left open a gap so that I could turn it inside out. For help with doing so, I trimmed all the excess seam allowance and thoroughly clipped all of my corners to ensure the smoothest turn. I then proceeded to pin and sew the back pieces to the shoulders. Once the shoulders had been sewn in place, I sewed a length of fabric 2 inches in width to finish the collar off. If you end up fitting your chemisette correctly, unlike I did, then you won't have to add a little extra bit of space in the back. But yesterday I didn't feel like, I don't know, something happened and it ended up about 2 inches short, which is my fault. If you just fit it correctly, this won't happen. After I had fixed my little problem, I added a buttonhole to the center front of the collar. This will be used so that the collar stud can be used to attach the detachable collar. Time for false buttons. Now that it actually fits around my neck, I can add the closures. I chose to use buttons, but hooks and eyes would work just as well. So I did not film this bit because it, one, took a while, and two, was just really finicky and fickle to try and work with. But I made a pattern for a detachable stand-up collar, and I will hopefully figure out a way to have this as a downloadable pattern in the description. But we'll see how this comes out. It fits really well, so I'm going to go get the fabric, and we're going to try and figure out how to put this baby together. Once the pattern was all figured out, I began cutting it out of my cotton fashion fabric, as well as stiff interfacing. Thank you. Taking a sharp pencil, I traced around the original pattern to ensure that when I sewed it together, I could create as close of a shape as possible to the original. The next thing to do is to sew all the layers together very carefully, taking time to ensure that you stay on the line. After I stitched it all together, I very carefully cut off the seam allowance and clipped the corners so that it would turn nicely. Once all the corners were clipped, I turned it over and stitched the back up, ironing it nice and flat. folded it and then ironed it again. One of the more difficult things about fitting the collar is figuring out where the buttonhole should be placed. You could just skip this step and keep it closed with a brooch or a pin. I, however, opted for a buttonhole so that I could use a collar stud.
From the brain that brought you the Big Ben caper, the head that made headlines in every newspaper, and wondrous things like the Tower Bridge job, that cunning display that made Londoners sob. Now comes the real tour de force. Tricky and wicked, of course. My earlier crimes were fine for their times, but...